Okay, today we're going to install nose savers on this 2014 Corvette. There's been some questions on the message boards as to how to install them, and a few guys said they don't fit. So we're going to put them on right now. We're going to show you how easy it is to install. All right, so what we're looking at is the nose savers. Essentially, the left side, the right side, and all it takes to install it is essentially probably 2 half-inch wrenches, so you can hold it on both sides. So once we don't actually tighten the bolts, it's easier for transportation, but once you get the, you put the bolt in to assemble it, you'll use 2 half-inch wrenches to snug these up so the wheel will still turn, and then you just use 1 half-inch wrench simply to tighten it up. So the only drill you need is essentially a 5/16 drill. Now I'm gonna drill a pilot hole. You'll see me drill a pilot hole. I just think it's easier because you're underneath the car. And I'm also using an angle drill, which, you know, I guess some guys are gonna say it's cheating because it's gonna be hard to do it, but you can use a regular drill, and obviously if you don't have a floor jack, then you're gonna need to get it up on blocks because we recognize the Corvette's a little bit low, but this is all it really takes to install a nose saver, so we're gonna show you how to do it right now. Okay, so the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna remove this one bolt. You don't need to do it, but it just makes it easier so when I take this, I can get it up flush and I can get my exact location of where I want it. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna cheat. You can use a pencil or a scribe. I'm simply gonna use a little bit of liquid paper. It's just easier for me, and it's also easier to photograph it and you can see it. So I'm gonna hold this up flush right here, and I'm gonna cheat a little bit. I'm gonna kick it up a little bit higher to make up for the plastic. And then if you look, get over here at this angle, then you're gonna see I'm just gonna put a little dab of liquid paper. So now I know that my hole for this needs to go right there. It's nice, it'd be nice if I had better liquid paper, but. So there's my one hole. And then we'll just duplicate to the other side. Okay, so what we're gonna do here is I'm gonna use this punch to set my hole so the drill doesn't skid away. You don't really need to use the punch, you just need a steady hand, but I wanna look professional on video. So then I'm gonna line it up right here. So we drilled our pilot hole, and now we're gonna do the other side. And again, I removed that 10 millimeter just so I get an easy shot at it. So you'll notice that when I put the holes in there that they're a little bit high, but that's to be expected. Nothing to worry about. Obviously, you don't want to get totally cocked. You want to make sure you get as plain as you can, but there we go. And now we're simply going to put the nose saver straight through. You'll see I put the 10 millimeter bolt back in. Just goes straight in. Let's get all the stuff out. And put my flat washer on it. And I don't know if you can see, but look how much length we give you. Someone had said the stud was too short, but you can see that we give you the perfect length for that. So you'll see the wheel still turns and it's nice and snug. And then over here, then I'll chase it with a wrench just to make sure it's the proper tight. And there you go. So we're done on one side, now we'll jump over to the other. There we go. See if we can get a little tighter. Well, that's actually pretty good right there. Okay, and there we go. So it runs dual notchy bearings, so they're ball bearings on both sides. And I guess I'm getting nervous because I'm on film here, but they're perfectly tight. That was good. And there we go, we're done with the nose savers. And as you can see, they sit perfectly level with the core support on both sides. And if he ever goes up a driveway, these nose savers actually, based on this core support, and because the bolt goes through, it squares it up, and now it'll lift the whole car up. Some people was asking, well, will that bolt hold? It seems like it'll just snap off, but no. Because it goes all the way through, it's welded to the frame, to the frame of the wheel brace, that now it's totally square when you tighten it up. So it'll actually lift the whole car up. So there you go. Any questions, let me know. I'm Joe Granatelli, and I appreciate your time.